Hello and welcome to the episode 184 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, among other things, we have a return home, the start of a nightmare, and the recording of two McCartney's classics. Let's start with the arrival of Pete Best, George Harrison, John Lennon, and Paul McCartney in Liverpool on the 3rd of July 1961. The four had travelled for 2 days from Hamburg, West Germany, where they had worked non-stop from the 1st of April of the same year. The band decided to take a well-deserved short holiday before resuming gigging. On the 3rd of July 1962, the same lineup of the Beatles performed a lunchtime concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool, their 190th in that venue, counting lunchtime shows alone. In 1963, we have another BBC radio session, this time to record a show for the Beat Show programme at the Playhouse Theatre in Manchester. The whole recording, including the rehearsal, took place from 4 p.m. to 9 p.m. in front of a live audience. The Beatles performed From Me to You, A Taste of Honey, and Twist and Shout. The program was broadcast on the 4th of July between 1 and 1:30 p.m. In 1965, the Beatles reached Barcelona, Spain, after leaving Madrid at 2:45 p.m. In the evening, they performed another one-show night for the conclusion of their European tour. The four were supposed to be on the stage of the Plaza de Toros Monumental at 10:45 p.m., but there were some issues and they were delayed until 11:20 p.m. The Beatles weren't too impressed by the fact that a large number of kids had been left out of the bullring, while the mayor and a host of rich and influential locals were allowed in. And, let's be honest, I won't be too impressed myself if you don't at least take a look at the www.simonmas.com/support webpage. If you're enjoying this podcast, it is of fundamental importance that you do something to support me in any one of the ways outlined there. The alternative is that I will have less and less time and resources to devote to the creation of music-related content that everyone can enjoy. Please vote with your actions and show me how fab you are. Thank you! On the 3rd of July 1966, the Beatles left Tokyo, Japan, at 10:40 a.m. After a 70-minute stopover in Hong Kong, they eventually landed in Manila, Philippines, where they found some 5,000 fans to greet them, happy that the band had decided to visit dictator Marcos' country. The situation, though, almost immediately turned to worst. The local press immediately took a dislike to the band's quirky and disrespectful replies to yet another round of questions about their last haircut or Paul's wedding plans. This tone was nothing new for the band, bored of the inanity of the questions, but the local media was less than impressed by the press conference. Another sour point was the Beatles' obvious ignorance about Philippines, but the four had long stopped worrying about any historical or geographical aspect of their tour, due to the madness and reclusion of it all. The Manila Sunday Times, anyway, announced that the band had invited President Marcos, the First Lady and their kids to the shows, and were personally showing up at the party that the First Lady Imelda had organized on the 4th of July at 11 a.m. at the Malacanang Palace. It is not clear whether the band and their entourage hadn't known about the party or if they had vetoed the presence of the Beatles there, but it seems that the problem lied with the local promoter, a Ramon Ramos Jr., who had failed to communicate, either with the authorities in fear of retaliation or with Beatles manager Brian Epstein in fear of a refusal. Anyhow, the Beatles themselves couldn't find out anything about the situation because, after the press conference, they had been taken to a yacht owned by a local VIP, without their roadies Neil Aspinall and Mal Evans, and without Epstein. They were told that they were to spend the night there, isolated from the rest of the world, protected by gunned policemen marching to and fro on the deck of the ship, but attending a private party with rich Filipinos. Another party in 1967, this time held in London, at the Speakeasy Club. The event, put together to celebrate the presence of the Monkees on the premises, saw the participation of John and Cynthia Lennon, Paul McCartney and Jane Asher, George and Patty Harrison, along with other guests like Eric Clapton, Manfred Mann and his band, members of The Who and of Procol Harum, and others. Let's close this episode with two recording sessions, the first of which taking place in 1968. On this date, the Beatles were at the EMI studios between 8 p.m. and 3:15 a.m., starting the work on Oh Bloody Oh Blada, with the recording of 7 rhythm track takes featuring Paul McCartney on acoustic guitar and vocals and Ringo Starr on drums. Overdubs of a proper vocal track and more acoustic guitars were added on take 7, after it was chosen as the best one. Paul had second thoughts almost immediately though. After the overdubs were recorded, he changed his mind and decided that take 4 of the rhythm tracks was actually better, and re-recorded more acoustic guitar parts onto that, adding distortion so that it sounded like an electric guitar. This attitude of Paul with some of his songs, of recording them time and again in search of perfection, would get worse over time and eventually concur to widen the gap between him and the rest of the band in the months to come. In 1969, another recording session focused on another number by McCartney, with George, Paul and Ringo busy at the EMI studios with Golden Slumbers Carry That Weight. After an edit of the previously recorded take 13 with either take 14 or take 15, which created the definitive basic track still named take 13, the three enriched the result with overdubs of rhythm and lead guitar, 2 lead vocals and background choirs. The work started at 3 p.m. was completed by 8:30 with a couple of reduction mixes, producing take 17. John Lennon was absent, still recuperating at the Sutherland Hospital in Scotland after his car crash. Having said this, there's little more to add for today's episode. Tomorrow, we'll see how the Philippines fiasco developed. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.